This video provides an introduction to the course that I hope that you never need, but unfortunately, weight loss surgery is not perfect, and neither are we. And as a result, sometimes weight regain occurs after surgery. So the first and I think most critical thing that any weight loss surgery patient should come to understand is that weight regain after surgery is possible. There is certainly this school of thought that I've picked up on in my patients that somehow if from a sleeve gastrectomy the stomach is made very small, or from a gastric bypass the pouch is made small and the food is rerouted through the intestine differently, that makes it impossible to ever eat enough food or absorb enough calories in order to gain weight. And anyone who has gone through this surgery recognizes that things change quite a bit from the first few months, and that you will be able to eat again, and you will be able to absorb calories. And because of that, you absolutely, positively will be able to regain weight. In fact, over time, I believe every single weight loss surgery patient will struggle to some degree with weight regain. The big question and issue is timing. Now, this is not an absolute truth. And one thing we know for certain is that there is a tremendous amount of variability in the amount of weight that's lost after surgery. And those patients who lose the most weight, who have the most powerful effect from surgery, tend to also be the most resistant to significant weight regain. The patients that I'm the most concerned about in terms of weight regain are those who lose less weight than we would expect, less than average. They haven't had as powerful of an effect. Their set point hasn't lowered as much. It hasn't anchored at that new lower position. And as a result, they're more susceptible to weight loss than other patients. We can see weight regain as soon as 18 months after a sleeve gastrectomy. That is not a very long time. Thankfully, it doesn't happen this soon very often, but it absolutely positively can. With a gastric bypass, we tend to get a little bit more time, somewhere in the 3 to 4 year range, but really it's kind of 5+ years, and with a sleeve, kind of 3+ years, where we start to see this happening more frequently, and that kind of is the most common time that people will start to struggle with weight regain. Now, having watched the other courses where we talk about the honeymoon years and the end of the honeymoon years, I think at this point you hopefully will have recognized that this does not mean that you get a 3 or 5 year pass from having to worry about nutrition and worry about exercise. Because if you take that approach, where I'll figure this out when it becomes a problem, you've really set yourself up for failure. You haven't used this surgery to launch a new and healthier lifestyle, which is the most critical component of maintaining your body weight and preventing weight regain. Now, there are really two components to the amount of weight that's lost. The first is the amount of weight that you lose. So the amount of weight that you lose is primarily determined by your genetics. And the studies are fairly clear on this. We're starting to recognize genes that actually we can use to predict how much weight someone's going to lose. We also see that this runs in families. If your brother or sister has had great success after weight loss surgery, the chances are so will you. If your brother or sister, and it actually is first degree siblings, meaning parent or child as well, has had very poor or average weight loss, chances are you will too. So the amount of weight loss, how much you lose in that first year or 18 months after surgery, is primarily driven by genetics. Your behavior, your lifestyle doesn't play a huge factor in how low you go. There's some play there, don't get me wrong. This is not an absolute 100% true statement, but probably around 90% of the influence of the amount of weight that you lose is from your genetics. But when we look at the durability, which is really saying the tendency to either stay at that lower weight or to regain weight if it's not durable, what we find is that the opposite really rings true, that this is primarily lifestyle. that those people who are exercising regularly, who are eating very well, tend to be much more resistant to weight regain than those people who aren't doing the best they possibly can with their after surgery in terms of managing their lifestyle. So the amount of weight you lose is driven by your genetics, but the durability of that weight loss is where lifestyle comes in. So what causes weight regain? There are many causes, and the truth is that most of what's going to be presented in this course is actually also presented in nutrition in the nutrition course number one, where we talk about the causes of set point elevation and the ways to lower your set point. So the big three, the top three causes of weight regain that I see in my practice are medications. Patients being started on a medication that causes weight gain without their knowledge or understanding of how much this drug can influence their body weight. And only after 15 or 20 pounds has been gained do you start to maybe put two and two together and say, huh, this weight gain all started when I started taking this drug. You go online, you look it up, and you say, whoa, yeah, this drug can cause a lot of weight gain. So without question, managing your medications appropriately after surgery is really critical to preventing weight regain. The second is processed foods. Getting back on the processed food train, especially sugar-sweetened beverages, can cause significant weight regain. And adoption of the Pound of Cure program, where it's primarily unprocessed foods like fruit and vegetables and nuts and seeds and beans that dominate your diet, that will help you prevent weight regain. Inactivity and injury, whether it's progressive arthritis leading to a joint replacement, or it's a torn meniscus from working out or playing sports or running or whatever it is, kind of being laid up on your back, losing muscle as a result, can cause significant weight regain. And there are several others. And if you go into nutrition course number one and look at the causes of set point elevation, each one of these items is spelled out. And I really urge you to go through those as well. We'll have videos in this section that cover the big three, but there's other causes as well. And if you're struggling with weight regain, I really urge you to go back to that course in addition to looking through this one, to help identify the causes of your weight regain, because if we don't fix those causes, we really don't stand much of a chance of getting the weight back off. So then when we talk about how to lose the weight again, we really get back to those same four methods that we've talked about a lot in course number one as well, where we talk about ways to lower your set point, but also throughout all of our discussion, identifying four methods for lowering your set point: nutrition, exercise, medications, and surgery. So with weight loss surgery, it's not first time surgery, it's a revisional surgery, which is a whole other thing and is very different and carries more risk and typically less benefit than the first time surgery does. So when we're looking at revisional surgery, we have to be very careful with this. And there are a lot of surgeons out there who are offering revisional surgery, but are the outcomes worth the risk? And I think that's something that is a difficult question to answer, but I'll try to give you some thoughts on that as well. And again, I really urge you to go back to nutrition course number one, where we talk about your set point and the causes of it going up, as well as what we can use to lower your set point. So this really represents a definitive strategy for addressing weight regain. Step one, identify the cause of the weight regain and eliminate it as much as possible. Step two, look at our four methods for lowering your set point and move through them systematically, changing your nutrition, adding an exercise if possible, exploring medications, and finally, if all else fails, looking for revisional surgery options. So if you're going to find success in battling weight regain, it absolutely requires that you are completely honest with yourself about what you're doing and what's happening with your lifestyle. How is your eating? If you are looking around you at your peers and family members and rationalizing that you are eating the same or maybe even less. And it's very common that people say, well, I'm eating the same, but I'm eating less. That's not enough. Eating less food is not an adequate strategy for maintaining your weight after surgery. We call this the portion control trap, and it's addressed in other videos as well. And it will not work as a long-term nutritional plan for managing your body weight for about 90 to 95% of all people who've undergone weight loss surgery. Instead, you must eat differently. So if you look at your plate and you look at your neighbor's plate and it's the same food, you've got to check yourself. This is the time where you have to start looking back, and we have all of these nutritional courses that go over exactly how to do it. I would recommend nutritional course number 2, getting yourself on the metabolic reset diet as quickly as possible, as essentially the definitive way to get your eating back on track if you're struggling with weight regain. Are you exercising? Oftentimes people will say, well, I'm active, I'm gardening, I'm on my feet all day at work, I'm running around after the kids, I'm very active. And I think that's great. You should be very active throughout the day. But exercise is something that requires a change of clothes. It's a defined period of time where you are putting in the energy and the effort to move your body. It does not have to take a long time. This is not 45 minutes or an hour on the treadmill, which is mind-numbingly boring in my mind. It can be a 20 or 30 minute high-intensity workout. If you're not capable of that, again, we have a course, number 4, that identifies strategies for exercising no matter what your level of fitness is. Are you maximizing that? Are you doing the best that you can when it comes to your exercise? If you're answering no to these questions, then we're already creating an action plan for getting you back on track so that you can lose weight. Are you stuck in the pill problem rut? The pill problem rut says, I have a problem, I go see my primary care doctor, and as a result, I get a pill. And that ends up increasing your medication list. And next thing you know, you're taking 6-8 pills. And guess what? One of them just happens to cause weight gain. And in our kind of 12-minute primary care doctor visit cycle that we're stuck in, we find oftentimes that this is what you get. You get a doctor who kind of says, well, you got a problem, let me give you a pill so I can move on to the next patient, not spending the time to educate you, to review your history, to recognize how important your weight loss has been to you and how important maintenance of this weight loss is. But this is the way our healthcare system is structured, and you really can't hate the doctors for it. You can't blame them. They don't have much choice in most situations. This is how they are essentially forced and encouraged to practice. And then finally, revisional surgery may be the answer. I do a lot of revisional surgery in my practice, but I found that it is not the absolute cure-all, and only as part of a comprehensive program, essentially giving you a second chance, but recognizing and understanding, hey, this has got to be it, because after that first revisional surgery, it's not like we can go back and make it smaller or lengthen things or do anything like that. Once you have one more shot, and oftentimes you don't even have that shot. For a gastric bypass, in my opinion, most of the time, there's not a lot of good revisional options. So to summarize, a systematic approach to weight regain is critical, and kind of going through each of these items that cause your set point to go up and eliminating them as much as possible, and looking at our 4 methods for lowering your set point and optimizing those as much as possible, is how you address this problem. It requires that you're honest about your current lifestyle and recognize that you may not be doing everything you possibly can in order to get the weight off, in order to prevent weight regain, and it's time for you to regroup and take those necessary steps.